Hey girlfriends, thank you so much for tuning into Tishby TV. Today's video is all about writing the perfect thank you card. The holiday season is over. Gift giving season is probably over for you, or it may be in full bloom. But I wanted to share with you this age-old tradition that I think will always be alive and thriving: writing the perfect thank you card. So if you've ever found yourself finding a difficult moment to sit down and write the perfect thank you, I have a few tips that I want to share with you in this video. You can find thank you cards anywhere. If you recently hosted an event and you had an invitation, you can order coordinating thank you cards to compliment your invitations. You can find these online. You can have them custom designed. You can make them yourself. I mean, you can find whatever you like. You may want your thank you cards to coordinate with your home decor or your office decor or your brand. After you have selected your card, you want to address the giver. So look at the gift tag that was with a gift or a gift card and make sure that you spell the giver's name correctly. And that's a sweet touch to start this card off with. Address the giver. Be specific about the gift. Now, this can be a tangible gift or it can be an act of kindness that you're wanting to send this person a thank you. Be sure to list that in the thank you card. It is just adding a little bit of extra detail and personality, and it really goes a long way when someone knows that you are grateful for something that they did for you. And your thank you could actually brighten someone else's day. So definitely give this a thought. And then if you received something that was tangible, include in the thank you card how you can use the gift. If it was a scarf, for instance, let them know that you look forward to wearing the scarf to an upcoming event, or you name it. Now, I like to add sequins to all of my thank you cards. This is just my way of adding something a little extra, and it's like a little party in a card. You can do something similar to this, or you can add nothing. If possible, avoid a digital thank you. In the digital age, this is something very hard to do, but I say just give this a shot maybe once or twice and see the reaction that you get after you send a physical thank you card. My clients usually ask, how do you properly mail these? And I always say, have the design facing you so when the recipient opens the envelope, they will see the design and can pull it right on out. And then just seal it with adhesive of your choice. I don't recommend licking the back of those. And on the front of the card, if you don't want to put two addresses on the front, use the front only for the recipient. So of course that will go in the center of the envelope. You can handwrite these. I always recommend handwriting them and use a ink of your choice, just as long as it is visible and the post office has no problems mailing these. And then your address will be on the back of the envelope. I hope this video helped you. If you had any questions about thank you cards and how to address them and what you should say, if you like the video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already subscribed, please do so before leaving the video. And I'd love to connect with you somewhere else, such as Instagram. You can find me over there at Tish Bullard. And girlfriends, until next time, design and live the life that you love. Have a great day. Bye.